Hey there. Subscribe to my channel. And also press this bell icon. So you never miss any new updates, cause whenever we upload new video you will get a notification on your phone.
All the time. The news media, radio, television, and newspapers really play it up big, especially if it's an offshore rig where the potential for pollution, loss of drilling equipment, and loss of life are greater than a land rig. But then it always happens to the other guy, the rig over on the next lease or down the road. That was probably what the guys on this blowout were hoping for.
Did this happen on your rig? Most people think blowouts occur because the drill bit hits abnormally high gas or oil sand, sends mud followed by gas or oil screaming up the hole to the derrick. All this is followed by fire, turns the drilling equipment into smoldering junk.
But studies made of blowouts in recent years have pointed out that the majority occurred in normally pressured field wells in which the oil or gas was known to be there. Additionally, the majority of blowouts occurred not when the zones were drilled, but while the pipe was being tripped after being drilled. When then could a blowout happen? Anytime a crew gets careless. It could be you. How's the best way to fight a blowout? The answer is not let it get away. Tame it when it first begins. That is, when it is still a kick. A kick is a potential blowout. A kick indicates that oil, gas, or salt water have entered the borehole. However, as a kick, it can still be controlled. The kick can be killed before it becomes a blowout.
Part of well-controlled training, then, is to learn as much as possible about the warning signs of a kick, thereby preventing it in the first place. Also, to learn about the equipment used to bottle it up should one occur. This program deals with shutting in a well while drilling. Other programs deal with kicks while tripping and how to kill a kick.
A kick doesn't just happen. It usually gives some warning. Let's look at some of the warnings and what to do about them. While drilling, the total volume of the mud varies somewhat because as a new hole is made, it has to be filled, causing the pit level to go down somewhat. However, water is usually added to the system along with the other materials that make up mud. Generally, they are added at the same rate at which the hole is drilled, resulting in the mud pit level staying more or less the same level. A kick while drilling is caused when the formation drilled into has a higher pressure than that of the mud column. The mud column acts as a plug holding the pressured formation fluid in. As the hole is drilled deeper, the formation pressure goes up. However, the mud column plug gets longer to balance out this pressure. Sometimes the pressure goes up faster than the length of the mud column. If we know this, we can make the column heavier by adding weight material like barite. This additional weight helps hold the formation fluid in check. If the mud column is not heavy enough, a kick can take place. That is, oil, gas, or water from the formation enters the well bore, forcing the mud plug out. The first sign of a kick may be a drilling break. That is, the rate of penetration speeds up. As the formation fluid enters the hole, the drilling gets faster. The driller can tell if he gets a drilling break by noting the drilling rate recorder. Another sign of a kick may be an increase in mud flow at the surface, followed by an increase in the mud pit volume. These increases may be picked up by one or more monitoring devices. They include a flow show device that compares the mud volume going in to the volume coming out, a mud volume measuring device that measures changes in flow line volumes, or a pit level indicator that measures the level of the mud in the mud pits. To eliminate the need to constantly watch these devices, they are equipped with alarms that are automatically sounded at some preset point. What happens now? An alarm is sounded. The driller picks the pipe up off the bottom. high enough so that the slips can be set if necessary. This done, the pump is shut down and the mud ditch or mud return line is checked. No flow means a false alarm. However, flow with the pump off means that fluid is still entering the hole. The well is kicking. If allowed to continue kicking, it would soon turn into a blowout.
So if the well flows with the pump off, the next step is to close the well in. The sequence may vary from one company to another, but the end result is the same. The well is shut in and the pressure contained.
Let's see what's happening downhole. The drill bit has gone into a pressured sand, and formation fluid is flowing into the hole, shoving the mud out around the drill pipe, up the hole, and out the bell nipple to the shaker. To stop the flow, a blowout preventer stack is used. Of course, if the kick happens when the hole is first started, only one big annular preventer is used. When it is closed, large valves are opened automatically to allow the fluid to go over the side. This is called a diverter system. It is not intended to hold very high pressures. Once the surface casing is set and cemented in, the blowout preventer stack is nippled up, and higher pressures can be handled safely. Let's look at the BOP stack a little closer and see how it can act as a valve to shut off the flow of mud, thus shutting off the flow out of the drilled hole. There are two types of preventer valves used in the stack, annular and ram. The annular preventer contains a large round rubber and steel sealing element. It is located inside the preventer with a tapered upside-down bowl-looking cover with a hydraulic piston below it. When activated, the piston shoves the rubber up into the bowl, squeezing it together. With enough pressure, it will squeeze around the pipe, sealing it off. By controlling the pressure to the piston, the pipe can be moved with the annular preventer closed. Below the annular preventer are two or more ram-type preventers. These contain two rams with grooves and sealing elements. When pressure is applied to the backside, they are forced into the hole. The set of rams is required for each pipe size and one set for no pipe. They are distinguished by calling them pipe rams and blind rams.
With the preventers closed, a means of controlled circulation has to be established to pump out the kick and establish control with the mud.
This is done by opening a hydraulically operated valve below the preventers. Hydraulic pressure moves a piston up or down, opening or closing the valve.
From here, the mud and formation fluid goes to the choke manifold. The choke's a means of controlling the flow from the well, much the same as a faucet controls the flow of water from a water line.
The choke manifold contains more than one control device and valves to route the mud to the control system that will be used. They include
a valve-type choke that can be opened and closed by the driller from a remote station, a hand-operated valve-type choke, and fixed orifice types. This is a plug with a small hole. The rate of flow can be controlled by changing the size of the hole.
From here, the mud goes to a mud gas separator, which removes any gas that may be trapped in the mud and vents it to a safe area. A vital part of the blowout preventer stack is the accumulator unit. As the name implies, this unit accumulates or stores hydraulic fluid under pressure to operate the various valves in the BOP stack. There are several types of accumulators available, but they all operate more or less the same. A pump that is either air or electronically operated takes the hydraulic fluid out of the reservoir and pumps it under pressure into a bottle. The bottle can be shaped as a sphere or as a cylinder. Inside the bottle, there is a diaphragm or sleeve. A gas, usually nitrogen, is placed on one side of the bottle under pressure. As the hydraulic fluid is pumped into the bottle, it tends to compress the gas, holding the fluid under pressure. As the fluid is allowed to leave the bottle, the pressure will drop. To make sure that enough fluid is available at a pressure high enough to close all the preventers, several bottles will be tied into the system. From the accumulator, hydraulic lines carry the fluid under pressure to two or more control panels.
These are a series of valves that direct the hydraulic fluid to the annular ram and remote valves to open and close them. The panel is marked to show which valve is for each component and which way to move it to open or close it. With the outside bottled up, The well is now a closed system in that the pressure is transmitted through the system.
This acts sort of like a car tire. Air enters under pressure at the valve stem, but it acts over the entire tire on the sides as well as the bottom. Likewise, oil, gas, or water enters the well under pressure. When shut in, this pressure can be measured at the choke manifold. This is called casing pressure and is one indication of how much fluid has entered the well. Once a well kick is closed in, the supervisory personnel can take steps to remove the kick and pump in mud to kill the well. Another indicator of well pressure is the bottom hole pressure, which is indicated as the pressure in the drill pipe once the well has been shut in. This reading is called the shut-in drill pipe pressure and is used to calculate the mud weight needed to kill the well. The pump usually provides the seal needed to keep pressure from escaping through the drill pipe. An upper Kelly cock located just below the swivel may be used to shut in the drill string should the rotary hose or piping leading to the pump fail. To review, a blowout does not just happen. It gives warning signs. The most important sign is more mud coming out of the hole than going in. This should be picked up by the mud monitoring systems. For example, mud measuring devices, pit level indicators, or the presence of gas. Any indication of a kick should be checked by picking up the pipe and turning off the pump to check for flow.
If no flow is present, go back to drilling. But if the well flows with the pump off, it should be shut in and kill operations initiated.